Okay, so this is what I do. This is their veggies. It's everything I told you to get, but we chop it up fine. So that's what it looks like. It's pretty fine. So that way they can't throw stuff out, because they will. They'll pick out their favorites and throw the rest out. I hope my voice is going okay. This is the grain I told you about. I showed you the picture of. If you need another picture, I'll send you another picture. But that's the grain. And I keep it all in baggies, like you see here, in the refrigerator. And this is leftover sweet potato. I just leave it in there. And it's fresh casing instead of digging it out or freezing it. In the beginning, we froze it. I don't do that anymore, because like I told you, I learned along the way what to do and what not to do. Okay, so that's all dug out. And then this is the rest of that sweet potato. And I just dig it out. And I scrape it off the peel when it hangs down like that. And that I'll just put back in the baggie. I forgot my fork. Whoops, I left some peel on there. Zaz likes potato peel, but you gotta wash it first. These have already been microwaved. That was a good sized potato. The average sized potato gets microwaved for 5 minutes, but if they're bigger, they can get microwaved for like 6.5 minutes. We take a knife and we like, see them cut marks, and just whack it all the way around and then microwave it. And see, this is kind of dry, so I'll add some water to it, because African Greys don't drink much water, so if you can add moisture to their food, that's good, because they need some water. I mean, they drink when they're thirsty, they know what they need. But anyway, you see me cutting it up or mashing it, or you don't want to leave it chunky, because they'll pick up chunks and throw them out and waste food. And we don't waste food. Trust me, we don't waste food. And in the groups, they'll tell you the rest of their pellets they don't eat at the end of the day, throw them out. We don't throw them out. Zaz don't eat pellets at night, so I don't give him pellets at night. The pellets that he don't eat, we strain with the strainer. Like this. And give them to Ethel. Because she eats them at night. Zaz don't eat pellets at night. So anyway, there's the sweet potato. Here's the grain. That goes in there. And see it. Well, we have three, so we're giving them more than what you're gonna give her or him at a meal, like a spoonful, because you're just trying it out and getting them used to it. You might not even want to give them that much, because like I said, we don't waste food. So give her like a spoon, because it might startle her at first, and she just might look at it, or she might throw it all out, or she might even be afraid of it. So that's it. You see? Sweet potato, grain, and the veggies. And the microwave it just to warm it up. Like 25 seconds. Or 30. You don't want it hot. You know, you feel of it. Put your fingers in it. See what it's like you would for a baby. That's what you do. I got too much in here, so I won't use all this. See, just check it. And so here's their dishes, and you're probably gonna give your one gray a spoon. It's a regular spoon like this, or a little more. because you got to test them. You don't know if he's going to throw it out, but see, ours get a little more because they eat a little more. Well, Mose doesn't eat much. He's the picky eater, but I give him a little more than I know he's going to eat because that might be the day he chooses to eat more, because I always try to get him to eat more. And Zaz is a little piggy, and so I want him to eat less. And Ethel is just Ethel. She eats. She eats better some days than others. And then I just put a spoonful in. And what's left, I divide up. And this, I'll put this leftover sweet potato, I'll put right back in this casing, put it back in the fridge. And then I just, you don't want to like stir it and stir it and stir it to where it's like mush. I just take my spoon and go like this, the end of it, because I don't want to mash it. I just want to toss it around. And then you'll see another why we cut it up so small. It's recognizable, but it's hard for them to pick out their favorite thing, because you want them to eat it all, not just their favorite. Some of that, see, I cut a little bit too big. Piece of broccoli or something. They're gonna throw it out, because it's too big. Because they might see something right next to it they want, so they'll throw out the big one to get to the other thing they want. That's just what they do. And I put it like in the middle. And the reason for that is they move it all around to eat. And I can tell by looking how much they've eaten, to where if you leave it all spread around, they just dig in it and they'll still throw it out. But they don't throw out that much anymore because I learned how they eat and what to do. But anyway, I do this so that it's easier to tell how much they've eaten. So, that's your lesson for today. Wait a minute, I'll show you one other thing, if I can find it. They get fruit a couple times a week, and the only thing they like is apple and red grape. They don't like green apples. Ours only like red apples. And never give them the core of an apple, because the seeds have got cyanide in it, just naturally. It's a small amount, but they have little bodies, and it wouldn't take much. It could kill them. And I don't know if you can see what I'm doing. Just, you know, cut it in slices. And you've only got the one, so you might just want to give them one like this. And if I was you, I wouldn't even give them any apple yet, because you're trying to teach them to eat food, you know, other healthy things you want them to eat. So don't give them stuff like this that you know he'd rather have, because you want to teach them to eat. They have to learn what food is. Because you might, you know, be feeding them good stuff that he's never seen before. They know what's edible and what's not edible. And you're just going to be making a small amount of this at a time. And yeah, that's a small amount to make in the microwave. You should make enough to last like 3 days with a tad extra. So you're going to be making them like this much, like a handful. Because it shrinks a little bit. And when I cook it in the microwave, being frozen, it's got moisture on it, you know, like, not ice, but you know what I mean, from being frozen. So you won't need to add any water. But if you want to dribble some water over the top, you can. But I make this thing full when I make it. And it lasts like 3 days, maybe into the fourth day. And You always want to check it to make sure it's still good, because they know when it's not good and they're not going to eat it. Use your fingers and go like this. You know how stuff feels slimy if it's not good? Well, this is perfectly fine. This was just made yesterday. But I just have these containers. I save them. I get them from the deli at our grocery store, how you can buy a quarter of a pound or something or whatever. And they put them in these. I save these, and that's what I put their veggies in. And this whole container, cut up fine, like I told you we cut it fine, fills up these two at a time. So that's how fine we cut them. You can maybe kind of see. Where's the camera? I don't know. But anyway, this one hasn't even been used, because like I told you, we just did it. And you can see some chunks that are too big. And if you get them too big, just take your kitchen shears or scissors, cut them up or whatever. There are some grays that like to hold their food, but you can let them do that sometimes, but then that encourages them to hold other foods, and then they might start throwing things out if they can't hold it. So you just have to learn your gray and find out what he likes and don't like, and learn his bad habits, if you want to call it that, and then change them. So anyway, there's their food dishes. And just pick up some apple and put it on top. We do this a couple times a week. And that's their fruit. Or you can just give them the apple as a snack. And just kind of mix it in so they have to eat it with it. But they're going to eat the apple first anyway. Because they're like a kid. That's what a kid would do. But after they eat the apple, they're going to eat their other stuff. So, that's what you do. I mean, that's what we do. You'll find your own way and what you like to do and what he likes and doesn't like. And you might find a whole way of doing it. And that's good. You have to do what works for you. And this is 12 minutes. And I don't know if it's going to upload. I'll try it. Bye.